So the topic today is, how much are you loaning to the bank? You know, some of us look at the bank and we don't realize what we're really doing, you know. So think about it for a minute. If you have money sitting in your bank account right now, you know, $5,000, $10,000, $20,000, $30,000, whatever amount of money you have sitting in your savings account, think about what you just done. You took your hard-earned dollars, your hard-earned dollar, your $20,000, your $10,000. This is what you did. So let me share the screen. You know, this is what you're doing. You took your money and you walked into your banking institution and you loaned them $10,000. You gave them $10,000. You didn't do a credit check on this bank. You didn't qualify them before you gave them that money. All you did was go hand them your money with no questions. Imagine that. And then the bank has the nerve, right? This is your money. You just loaned them $10,000. Now they give you, today I'm being generous, 1% interest. But we know most banks don't even do that. They give you interest because you loan them money. So now they say, okay, we'll charge you, we'll give you 1% interest or 0.1% interest for the money you just loaned us. See, I know a lot of you don't ever think about it that way. You never put that together. You always think that, oh, I'm just putting money in the bank. No, when you have a savings account at your local bank, what you're doing in that savings account is you're loaning your money to the bank. I don't have a savings account at a bank. The only bank I have a savings account with was a bank that I had to finance when I was buying my car, right? It was a credit union. They needed me to open up an account, so I put $5 in there to open it up so they could give me a loan so I could use their money to do, you know, finance a car. And I got a great interest, was like 1.5% interest because they were doing a promo. And because of my great credit, they gave me 1.5% interest. And you know me, I always finance for the longest time. So I did 84 months. If you go watch some of my videos on YouTube, you see some of those topics on why I do that. Because I believe my money is more important to me and I got to invest in myself than giving it to a financial institution. But that's a different conversation. So now you loan, the bank loans you, you know, give them $10,000 and they turn around and loan it to you at 0.1% interest or 1% interest. But here's what happens. The next day you walk back to the bank and you apply for a credit card and they give you a credit card limit, $10,000, or you apply for a bank loan. All they're doing is giving you back your money. Now you might say, hey, I have a loan. I have my money in Bank of America, but I have a credit card with Chase. In your mind, you're saying they're two different people. No, they're not. They're all the same. They're all related. They are related, and they're just moving money around, right? So you go in and you loan them, you know, you loan them your 10 grand. They turn around, loan it back to you, and look at what they charge you. 8%, 17%, 4%, 29%, depending on your credit. And in fact, you got to apply to receive that money back from them. You have to go back and apply with the bank to get your money at an interest. Isn't that something? Why ain't you upset with that? Right? Why are you not mad about that situation? Of course, you feel like, you know what? I have no choice because this is all I got going. I don't really have a choice. You know, that's what it is. And you live with that and you accept that nonsense from these banks. And yet, so many of you still do it every day. When we show you a different place to park your money, what do you tell me? You're like, oh, why should I put? I've heard people say, why should I put money in cash value life insurance? You hear some of you that are Dave Ramsey fans and Susie Orman fans that listen to them. I call you Susie and Dave Ramsey disciples. You have no problem listening to those two jokers that say to you, hey, don't have money in cash value life insurance because you should never put money in cash value life insurance. But yeah, they also promote you to do what? Put money in a savings account at a local bank. And you're not upset about it. They tell you, go to your local bank and put money in your local bank, your savings account, and turn around, have this bank loan you the money on a car. Loan you the money credit card. Loan you back your money when you're buying a property. You see that, folks? That is a crazy, crazy stuff. But most people are doing it. They don't really realize that that's what you're doing. We go and we loan the money to the bank, and then the bank turn around loan it back to you and charge you a high interest rate. This is the same thing France is doing to all the African countries, that the French countries that France colonized. They take their money and loan it back to them at a high interest rate. It worse than this, actually. And they wonder why the third world countries can't grow. Because this is slavery on a different level. And then when we fast forward here in this country, we are allowing the banks to hold us captive. And so many of you are doing this. If you have $20,000, $5,000 in a savings account today, you need to watch this video and think back and say, why am I doing this with the bank? See, I have a checking account with bank. That's all you really need at a local bank, just a checking account to pay your bills. You don't need anything else. You don't need to have any other type of account in a bank, just a checking account. No, you don't need a money market account in a bank. You don't need all that. You just need a checking account to pay your bills. You need to put your money in an account that's gonna allow you to do two things with your money. I use Casual Life Insurance to park my money. Why? Because it gives me life insurance protection on my life, right? So in case something happens, because we know life is going to end one day. We just don't know when. But whatever it happens, I need to make sure that whoever I'm leaving behind, I'm going to be able to continue living the same lifestyle that I've created for them. So I put stuff in place to make sure that happens. But in the meantime, I park my money in Casual Life Insurance, and then I could leverage it to invest in a lot of different businesses that I have interest in, all right? That I have interest that's going to give me double-digit returns. See, that's the key, folks, is parking the money and using it as leverage. Why are you parking your money at a local bank and you expect them to benefit you, and then you walk in and they have the nerve to do what? Deny you a loan. This is the reason I'm doing this, because one of my clients was telling me that she had this 75 years old lady, right? That has, check this out, this is how much she has in her bank. She has $2 million sitting in a savings account at a local bank. 75 years old. Now, check this out. She needed a loan to buy a house. She's 75. She wanted to buy a property, you know, but she didn't want to take her $2 million to do it. She didn't want to pay cash for the property. So what she wanted to do was borrow the money from the bank to do it. Look at how much she wanted, $800,000. That's it. That's all she needed, $800,000. She has $2 million. But what did the bank do? They have to check her credit, first step. They have to do what? Again, ask her. They said to her, listen, we're going to check your credit. We also need to see how much money do you make. Do you have a job? Well, she's retired. She don't have a job. She don't have anything. So they denied her the loan. They didn't give her the loan. They said, no, we're not going to loan you the money. Imagine that nerve. I mean, we were able to help her because, you know, I have relationships and we could do certain things. There's a lot of stuff that we can do. So we're able to take care of her. But my point is, this is what is happening every day in, you know, all over the world, not just here in America, all over the world. So, folks, if your financial advisor is telling you to put money in a savings account at a local bank, you need to fire that financial advisor. Let me say it again. You need to fire that financial advisor because they don't know. They have no clue what they're telling you. All right. Because all they're doing is working for the local bank. Because when you need the money the most to do something, you get a no. They'll tell you no. So, folks, that's all I have for you. Okay? I just wanted to do this real quick, help you understand some things that a lot of us don't really look at. And because so many people don't understand this, life is happening. And they're losing out and they're missing out on things that they should be taking advantage of. So, again, please, share the video, like the video. Make sure you let everybody know about it. You know, again, Don't have people putting money in a local bank. Again, appreciate you. Have a great weekend. Bye-bye.